What is today? My favorite day. Story time Sunday.
Jimothy!
Jimothy!
Subscribe to Jimothy.
The real reason rappers wear purses.
I look fabulous, that's why. I know you see all this drip. Purse go match the sneakers. Sneakers go match the shirt. Shirt go match the watch. Watch go match the whip, okay? But enough about me. As a rapper, I only got like 2 hit songs, y'all. And that's about it. Now, a lot of you have been noticing a trend over the years. Rappers like Lil Uzi Vert, Young Thug, 2 Chainz, and Gunna, just to name a few, have been out and about rocking bags louder than the booth that nigga Craig used to sell back at high school. But the question is, why though? Why are them boys rocking big bags like that? Aren't conventional pockets enough? Do briefcases not fulfill the needs of those wanting to transfer valuable coin and paper currency? Did duffel bags go the way of the dodo bird, much like my gym membership 2.5 weeks into my New Year's resolution? I don't know. But what I do know is that rappers live an incredibly nuanced lifestyle to that of a regular person. One moment they may be in the studio spitting that next top 40 hit, next they could be doing donuts in an abandoned warehouse for their next music video. And next thing you know, they might be in a Target parking lot squabbing with the ops because they got caught lacking after they was popping shit on the internet all week. In any event, one thing's for certain. These niggas go have the bag on them like they mama just walked into the house and she screamed groceries in the car. These niggas got big bags on them like a conveyor belt in an airport. These niggas got so many purses you think a third world country got stuffed in the back of their closet getting to work stitching those ever extravagant outfit accessories. Now I have a few hunches as to why this is the case. Why so many rappers wear purses. First point. How the f*** you gonna slap a nigga upside the head in under 0.865 seconds with a maximum efficiency rate of 89.6 and a median range of about 72.000004? All while extending your swinging radius, or as some would like to call it, the danger zone, 2 feet, 1 inches, and 3 quarters. You damn sure ain't gonna do that with a backpack. Purses are meant to slap folks upside the head. Here's an example.
You know what? Cause I didn't mean to do that.
You think the wisdom of many generations of strong, independent women was all for nothing? You gotta be out your damn mind to think ladies been slapping folks with purses since their conception for no reason. Rappers are constantly getting in fights, and I bet you can't name even 3 rappers who rock a handbag that ever got stole off on before. Y'all remember when Lil Uzi Vert was finna beat the brakes off Rich the Kid? Why you think he ran? Uzi was about to smack the new freezer, the old freezer, the refrigerator, and the ice chest out of Rich the Kid with the power of every female ancestor on the face of this planet. Rich a smart man for hitting the dash, I'll tell you what. F*** higher insecurity when you're out there packing a lethal weapon. Next point I'd like to make. Some of these niggas got service animals, y'all. For real, for real. Think about it. How else are all these rappers prescribed medications such as cough syrup, Xanax, Percocet, etc., etc.? Our rappers are deathly ill due to the fact that our healthcare system has been slowly going to the shitter over the past few decades. And they are having to deal with their personal health issues reactively as opposed to proactively. Because Big Pharma out here making sure our rap idols are staying medicated. And service animals are the angels on earth that are making sure our beloved musicians are staying just healthy enough to make sure they can hit the booth with the fierceness of a lion in the wild. And where must all these so-called service animals hide, huh? That's right, you guessed it! Motherfucking 101 collector's bag hand-stitched by the delicate hands of Alexander Wang himself. You can't go cheap on your baby! And service animals can be some of the most precious babies of all! By the way, shouts out to Paris Hilton for even starting this trend in the first place. Thank you, queen. Next point. You know how much shit you can put in a purse? Them things mad convenient, y'all! Remember when you was at church and your grandmammy told you if you could be quiet for the next 20 minutes during prayer, she would give you some sort of cinnamon flavored candy for your obedience and your lips would be sealed shut even though you know damn well your ass hates cinnamon flavored treats. And she was a woman of her word. God bless her heart, your grandmother. And after digging through her bag, pulling out napkins, maroon colored lipstick, 2 ounces of old people scented perfume, a banana, 2 Bibles, the Old Testament and the New, a small notepad with a pen she stole from the Holiday Inn jammed in between the rings, a leather belt ready to be used at any given moment if you start to act up on her watch, a metal pick with a fist on it that triggers PTSD in every nappy-headed motherfucker in existence, some car keys, and lastly, the half-eaten packet of Big Red bubblegum. All that to be said, her resourceful ass can fit a lot of shit in there, y'all. These rappers ain't stupid! They're just making room in their life for the most important things, such as one-time use N-word passes that they hand out to my melanin-lacking pale patrons at their shows, to the 14 pounds of sauce they must be carrying, which according to many, rappers having sauce is just a metaphor or something, but I'm pretty sure these rappers are out here cooking up in a stew. I'm just gonna assume they're using a tomato-based sauce because that's the most economical and it fits most people's palates. What do you think, marinara perhaps? Anyway, they just need to carry a lot of stuff, and a purse is the best way to do it. And now, for my last point. These rappers are equal rights activists! Yes, they are breaking down the barriers of society's gender norms! They are doing the hard work that many before them couldn't! You see Thugger in a brand new Michael Kors bag? Thank that man! Because he is in silent protest against the patriarchy! Did the nigga that invented the national anthem do that? No! Did the nigga that invented the classic but trademark song, Happy Birthday, do that? No! That song don't even slap anymore! It ain't got no kind of bass! Did that nigga named Beethoven do that when he composed the critically acclaimed Fifth Symphony in 1808? Actually, yes. That nigga was rocking Gucci bags before they were even in style. How else you think he fit all his cinnamon flavored bubblegum? So in essence, if you see a trap rapper out there rocking a Gucci bag, a Louis bag, Michael Kors, Fendi, what have you, you can compare their triple flow spinners to my nigga, the late, great, legendary Beethoven. Anyway, I'm finna go purse shopping at the Gucci store later. Y'all want anything? I love ya, and see you next week. Don't melt, because a milkshake can wait. You know what time it is, y'all. It's shout-out time. Welcome to the Cream Pack, new and old. Now, if you want to make it into next week's episode, all you got to do is comment down below or tell some friends about us. It really helps us to grow. Also, details for the monthly giveaway are in the description. All right, Cream Pack, shout-out to EH, Soviet Creates, LK, Daniel Tabaris, Hoser, though, and Tony Van Ginkle. I love you, and see you next week. Copy by myself, keep it black, like skin, not hurt, more red, like pen, so red, writing off my sins, not the same mistakes again, and I can never lose if I put love up in my head, I went, caught more love from my kid, don't need a stranger to tell me this, or that, I'm this, not that, copy, keep it black, so don't you talk that sweet, don't need that, I drink the coffee by myself, getting thoughtful by my-